If you surveyed 100 people and asked them what's the hardest part about being a content creator, I feel like 90 of them are going to tell you editing. Everybody says they hate editing. So I came up with this crazy series, DaVinci Resolve 20 over 40 in 30, and today is today 23, the GOAT, like Michael Jordan. Now, when it comes to editing, there are certain things that you could do, especially as a beginner, that will simplify the process of editing and make your job a heck of a lot easier. A lot of times you're watching a video and you see these really cool techniques and you think, oh my God, I'm never gonna learn how to do that. Well, here's a cheat code. Most pro editors are using something that we call plugins. Plugin is not the thing you plug in the wall to make your house smell like cinnamon during Christmas. It's a software that you run on top of your video editor that helps you do things like move a video up and down or zoom in, zoom out, add a title, bunch of weird things like that. Those things can add that spice that you're looking for in your editing process, but you just want to save yourself the time of not having to do it manually through stuff that's known as keyframing or animating, blah, 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 nerd words that you don't like, okay? So let me show you a couple that I found so far for DaVinci Resolve that I think are absolutely dope and well worth the money if you're going to get the sort of paid versions. Now, the first one that I'm going to show you does have a free version and a paid version. And just like DaVinci Resolve, there is the free version, DaVinci Resolve 20, and then there's the paid version, DaVinci Resolve Studio 20. When you hear someone say DaVinci Resolve Studio, that means the version that's worth $300 or costs $300. Now, this is important to know because some plugins only work in the Studio version because it requires things that are in sort of the AI side of it. You will see tons and tons of videos on YouTube saying that DaVinci Resolve free is more than enough for most people. And while that is true, you need to know by having this version, you are going to be missing out on some of the coolest things that DaVinci Resolve can do, especially when it comes to things like the AI auto mixing and some of the AI dialogue fixing, which means if you have bad audio, things of that nature, and the auto cuts, things of that nature, right? So I want to just say really quickly, for most of you people who are professionals, as far as meaning your job, your content is about your company, it's worth $300, dude. Just spend the money, especially if you're going to buy a speed editor. I have mine on the table down here. This thing right here is a speed editor. You can get that for $400 and it comes with DaVinci Resolve. So you basically pay $100 for a license for DaVinci, which will run on two computers. I just wanted to throw that out real quick. Because I understand most of the people, when you hear talking about, they're talking to maybe new creators or creators who are, say, kids, you know, they don't necessarily have that type of money. Fully understand. But as a professional, if you're in a professional in any way, shape, or form, it's probably worth your time to get the studio version, even though you'll hear most people say the free version does more than enough. I tell you why I did it, because I know if I spent the money, I would actually spend the time to learn how to use it. It's just go figure. Anyway, let me show you some of these plugins real quick and stop waxing. Okay, Mr. Alec Tech is an incredible content creator on YouTube, and he talks incessantly about DaVinci Resolve, and he has made these packs. And down here on the bottom of this page, here are the free versions of his pack. They will give you some animation things that will just literally save you so much time. So much time. And then zooms that will save you a lot of time. Now, me personally, the type of creator that I am, I like to support creators who make things to help out other creators, because I'm a creator who makes a product that supports other creators. So I went to go buy the anime pack, and I said, you know what? Let me just get both, because it was too cheap. I mean, honestly, $29 for this pack is way undervalued. This is easily $100 worth of stuff in here. So I just bought two because hopefully it helps this dude keeps making really cool stuff. And according to the video on his channel, he's constantly updating it. So I just want to support a really cool cat. And I'll show you what these guys do in a second. But if you click on this video here and go to look for the pack, you will see he has tons and tons and tons of amazing presets in here that will make your job so much easier. And I'll dive into these real quick a little bit, but I'm not going to give the full tutorial, because his tutorial is going to be way better because, well, he wrote it. You know what I'm saying? So I did buy that one. The other one I wanted to show you is motion VFX. If you follow my channel for more than 6 seconds, you have seen many of these motion VFX because I use a lot of them on my Final Cut side, but they do also make plugins for DaVinci Resolve. And so the ones I'm going to tell you to check out and download for free is the Hello DV, which is this one here. and the cam rig, which is this one here, and the M vertical. There's others in here, but these are the ones that make the most sense for what most of us are creating, especially as beginning content creators or people that are trying to, you know, make their business a little bit more profitable through video. These are the ones you're going to need: HelloDV, M cam rig, and M vertical. Okay. And when you do that, you're going to need something known as the M installer to install them, but installing them is relatively simple. It happens kind of sort of automatically. These ones down here that say they're free, they're just demos of paid versions. And this call out version is actually pretty dope. It's worth it, but you're going to pay like $99 for that particular one. So just go check out some of the stuff from Mr. Alex and save yourself a little time. Okay, so let's pop over back here real quick. I just want to remind you, the reason why I said to pay attention to plugins that say that they only work for Studio, because one of my favorite plugins that I found so far does only work in the pro version of DaVinci Resolve. So let me pop over real quick and show you what that is. And that is this Soundtrack Faster in DaVinci Resolve Studio from Epidemic Sound. This plugin is absolutely incredible. It helps you find music that matches your footage. It will auto remix and take out parts of the song that you don't need. Like, say, I really like this song, but it's too bassy for the talk that I'm going to give. You can make the drums and the bass come out. Like, this plugin is phenomenal, but because it's AI oriented, you kind of only can use it in the studio version. And I did a quick talk about this earlier. This plugin is phenomenal. So this is what I mean by it's kind of worth having the studio version. Okay, without further ado, I'm gonna give you a basic overview of what I found in Mr. Alec Tech that I just know will be a time saver and is well worth the download. And the reality of it is, what I'm gonna show you is available in the free options, but by supporting him, he does give you presets that makes it even faster. But look, it's a phenomenal plugin. It's definitely a must have for your DaVinci Resolve. So let's pop over into DaVinci Resolve real quick. I threw a couple of clips here on the timeline, and I'll just show you a couple. So he has something in here that's known as Magic Animate, and that is one of my favorite plugins. And so I did it here on this particular clip. So let me pop the cursor right there and just give it a play. And that was just to make the image just poop right out real quick, and then it'll play through, and then it'll poop back in. Right. And this one was the M cam rig version for motion VFX, because, you know, you might need to do that in order to put like something in the back and then have text over top of it. But let me show you what this sort of M animate guy looks like. So inside the M animate plugin here, you're going to drag it on to just add it. You would just drag it to the footage. And then actually, let me do it on this clip here. So we're going to take this guy and we're going to drag this M animate. Come on, fingers. We're going to drag this and just drop it onto the clip. Okay. So now it is applied to this piece of footage here. We're going to move this guy over, and then we are going to click upon the, and then let's show you some of the things that you can do. So you can embiggen the clip to make it fit. You can make it smaller, things of that nature, right? So like, say you want to stop it there, you can specify what is the center of the video. So like, if you wanted to come from a particular angle, of course, you can flip the footage back and forth or up and down if you wish. You can even control the twisty twist angle if you want to, right? Motion blur is always a good thing to add because it makes it look more realistic. You can say that I want to only affect the end of the clip or the out of the clip. And then if you come into the main animation controls, you have zoom control, right? So we just specify like when you zoom in and out. I like this concept over here of whip control. So that allows you to whip the footage in and whip the footage out. And so what that looks like is, as you come over here, it slides out. As it comes over here, it slides this way, right? And so this red line tells you that it needs to render in the background. So it hasn't finished rendering there, but you have full control over all of the start, stops, the positions, the whole nine of yet, including how fast it goes. You can even make it spin in or spin out, and you can dissolve it in or dissolve it out. So I don't want to make this take too long. So we're just going to give it a little bit of a big ups right here and give it a second, and that's going to re-render. Now I'm going to come back here to the top and I'll show you some of the zooms things that he added. I'm going to click on favorites, and then let's go to, he has this like DV loop zoom where, you know, I want to highlight a particular portion of the clip. He has things like, I want to put some text on there. So if I drag this on, I would write my text in this little side piece over there. Sorry, that's going to disappear when I move the mouse. But on the side of the clip, I can easily have a quick reveal because you're going through chapters, you're teaching the course. You want to like show everybody that we're about to get off to the next chapter. Like animating these things take a lot of time. Getting a preset like this that does it for you, so much faster, so much faster. And again, I believe all of these are in the free package. Just by, you know, giving the dude his $29, you get some presets that makes it even quicker, right? He has these things like, I mean, so many really nice ones. Now, this is just the ones that I favorited. There's a lot more in the pack, right? If I were to go over here to, toolbox and click on effects, there are all of these down here. This face cam stuff, this is all Mr. Alex right here. Like, all of these guys are in here. These reveals are sort of what I was just showing you. You can make all myriad sorts of reveals. And then he has, you know, image animations. If you're doing like a slideshow for your work environment or something like that, you got, so your images just aren't stagnant and sitting there. There's so many different ones in here. And again, I'm going to highly suggest you go and check out his video and I'll show you the things that came from the Zoom pack. So there's a couple of Zooms in here. One of the ones that I really, really liked was this guy right here, again, where you can do that little zoom on the person there. You can pop another bubble out. I like this one because, you know, you want to make sure that whatever you're highlighting is on. And of course, all these are editable. So if I was to drop this onto the clip here, I'm able to then move that around. So I'm not just like stuck with it right there. You would just click on the actual clip, make sure you're on the effects tab, and then you would adjust your zoom size here, right? And you want to move that little piece around. There's constant zoom curve. Where is it at? It's in here somewhere. Here's the effects tab. Okay, so you can adjust the height of that, the width of that. You can adjust how soft the edges are, right? And then you can move it around. If you click here on Fusion Overlay, then you should be able to just move this bubble by hand, which is super cool, right? You don't have to sit there and move all the sliders around, but you do have to turn that off when it gets done. Now, this needs to render. As you can see, the red and blue line, it's rendering in order to be able to show you what it's doing. But now that this one's done, let's take a look at this clip. You know, the family is playing, they're doing their thing on the beach, and we get towards the end of the clip. And as you can see, it hasn't finished rendering the automate out, but that's in there. So while this doing that, I wanted to show you one other thing real quick. I'm going to grab a vertical footage that we did yesterday, and then I'll take the sound part of it off because we don't need that. And I'll show you what that M vertical does from Motion VFX, right? So I have it down here on the side. I put M vertical. You're just going to drag this, pop it onto the footage. And instead of having, let me turn it off for a second. When you put a footage on the timeline that's vertical, it just looks dumb. It's just sitting there. It feels like it's pasted on. But by using this M vertical plugin, I could come in here and do some things with this footage, right? So I can rotate it just a wee bit or rotate it the other way, right? I can move the position over a little bit and leave some room for text. I can kind of control it up and down, you know, sort of like that. I can scale it back a little bit so it's a little floaty. And then for the background, I can make the background more zoomed in or zoomed out. I can control the fade of the background so you can see more that it is a replication of what's in the back. I can blur it more so it's not super obnoxious and, you know, like make multiple copies of it if that's the case. I don't think I need multiple copies because it fits inside this footage guy here. But by having these kind of controls, you can do so much more and make it just look better. Nothing looks worse than when you have a vertical piece of content just slapped onto the timeline and it just looks a little ill-matic, right? At least this way we could throw a text on there and let it do some things. So one of the things that I was going to show you is if we were to take like this little DV frame and drop it on here, that gives us the ability to put another piece of footage in there. And then if I were to go to this generators, and there's an image generator for the Mr. Admin. I'm looking for, there is a timeline thing. Here we go. I wanted to just put my search bar right on the top so you know where to get this thing from. I would click there and then go in here and adjust the settings. Give that a second. Type this right here and then there we go. So now you know where to like and subscribe to, right? So, I mean, these things are just make your job a heck of a lot easier. The thing is, you don't want to spend so much time playing around with this stuff to where you're just never going to get anything done because you're too busy trying to figure it out. It is much better for you to go get some plugins and make your job easier. I don't know who needed to hear this, but if it was you, let me know in the comments section below. Do yourself a favor, especially if you're just starting out. You don't want to have to go into the Fusion page and learn how to do all of that animating and stuff just to get these videos done. Go grab your plugins. Check out Mr. Alex Tech. Get a free plugin there. Check out Motion VFX. Check out the free ones. And you'll see what it is that you need. And then you can go out and buy the plugins that you're going to mostly use. I really think they save you a lot of time. In my Final Cut library, I probably have a few $1,000s worth of plugins that just makes that editing process so much faster. You don't want to be out here building charts by hand in the Fusion. You could, but you don't want to do that. It just takes too long. So that's my advice for any beginning editors out there. And if you like this video, press the like button, press the subscribe button, ring the notification bell. Also, check out the entire playlist because there's been 23 of these videos designed for DaVinci noobs so that you can learn how to use DaVinci the same way that I learned DaVinci, just by pressing all the buttons and doing all the things until you figure it out. But if you want to know some really cool stuff they could do, check out Mr. Alex Tech, because that dude is brilliant. I look at the DaVinci stuff he does, and I go, one day, fam, one day I'm going to be there. But we're taking it one step at a time. So right about now, the algorithm's going to show you another video to think you should watch. And I agree with him.
I need to know everything. Who in the what and the where, I need everything. Trust me, I hear what you're saying, but I like it's new what you're telling me. I'm curious, George. I hop in the Porsche, five and a horse. I'm ready for war. I'm coming for throws to turn to a ghost. I need to know everything. Now you be surprised at the info you get is by letting them talk, so I'm letting them talk. Gotta keep quiet, maneuver in silence, then let them in talk.